hope you're all doing well. I don't really watch makeup videos anymore, but sometimes a title grabs my attention, and that was Tati's, what was it even called? It was like, I don't know, something about like the being the best foundation ever, like not sponsored. And so I watched it and I thought, wow, I'm very much intrigued. She has sold me this product and I bought it straight away. I bought two shades, both were wrong. I bought them online, so I had to send them back. And then I got two more shades. It is the Smashbox Studio Skin Full Coverage 24 Hour Foundation. I bought shade 3, which is this shade, I think. Yes, medium undertone cool. And this is the one that Tati used. And I've got a fake tan on, so I think that's gonna be the right shade. Otherwise, I also have this one, which is the shade 2.15. I made sure both shades were cool because the first pair that I bought were not, and they were very pink. So essentially, I'm just gonna be trying this foundation out because trying foundations is my favorite thing to do when it comes to makeup. I don't know, it just sets the tone for the rest of your makeup. So I'm very excited to try this because she raved about it. And I mean, it's hard not to want to buy something when someone who has tried everything under the sun says it's life-changing. So let's do it. I'm really not a big Smashbox user, so I actually don't have like really any of their products, or many anyway. So I'm gonna use the Tarte Hydrating Primer like I spoke about in my last video, just to hydrate the skin. Now, as you can see, I do have a few breakouts, especially this guy here. That's just a scab, as gross as that sounds. It's just a scab, it's fine. I tacked it, it's fine, it's all okay. I bought this from Mecca and it was $55 Australian. What does it actually say? Weightless feel plus oil and shine control. Soft focus blurring effect, waterproof, sweat and humidity resistant. Yes, apparently a little bit goes a very long way. And when I spoke about it on my stories, a few of my followers said that they were looking forward to my review because they had seen mixed reviews. I hadn't seen any mixed reviews, although I didn't really look into any other reviews aside from Tati's. On the Mecca website, it seemed to have a good review. Sorry, a good rating. But foundation is very personal, so let's see how it goes. I'm gonna start off with that much, which is nothing. A lot less than I would normally start off with. But it does say apply a small amount. I'm gonna use this brush, and it's the Morphe Y5. I used it in my last video, and I had lots of questions about what I used. But I forgot, and now I remember, Y5. Let's hope this color is right. Okay, I'm gonna just dot it. It does feel like very souffle-ish, like moussey. Souffle is not the right word, mousse. Okay, so I've done some little dots. I think the color's gonna be fine. I actually didn't test it, but it should be okay. Okay, that's very high coverage. Let me get a mirror for myself. Okay, definitely should have mixed this, and I'm feeling like it's drying really quickly. I will have to take this off because that's definitely too dark, but that's definitely very like red. It's probably just not my shade. Okay, so that's a shame because I'm probably never going to be able to use that color then, because I'm like, I have like a darkish for me tan right now, and that's still way too dark. So I may have to part ways with that guy. That was a bit of a false start, but let's try that again. This is probably gonna be, I mean, look, just looking at it, yeah, I mean, that's fair. That one does look, this one might look too light when I first apply it, but I think once it oxidizes, because apparently this foundation oxidizes, once it oxidizes, hopefully that looks much better. To be fair, in Tati's video, she did say she had a Bora Bora tan. I do not have a Bora Bora tan. Not even a Bali tan. Just came back from Bali. Can't even say I got a Bali tan. That is the right color. And it's much more like, yeah, it's like more an olivey almost, less red. As you can tell by the brush, that was way too dark. Okay, let's start again. Ah, there we go. There we go. Okay, there we go. Dries really quickly. Okay, I'm gonna try on the other side quickly before this. Let me do that down my neck a bit as well, because it's obviously going to need that. I'm gonna try some of the Fenty Hydrating Primer, because I feel like this will be similar to the Smashbox one, because it has that like silky finish to it, which until I've tried it on, yeah, that kind of base, I'm not gonna pass comment on how quickly it dries too much. Like from that, that was like, yeah, that really, that was a couple of little dots. You saw how much I applied, like a few dots from like one little squeeze, and that's easily covered that side of my face instantly. Okay, let's try the other side. Let me zoom in. Applying it to the pimple. No, I think it just dries fast. I didn't notice a huge difference then. I can't believe how little you actually need. A lot of time foundations say that it's like, you don't need much at all. And it's like, if you want 2% coverage, then yeah, that's totally fine. No, it goes a long way, which I've got to love, because it means it'll last way longer. If you have to use less product, then obviously the foundation lasts longer. I feel like it might look nicer in the camera. Although it looks bad, but like, I just don't like how quickly it dries. It doesn't feel hydrating. What does the thing say? Oil and shine control. Okay, 24 hours. So I'm guessing this is for people that have oilier skin. And I kind of feel like my skin is on the oilier side these days. But, okay, I'm gonna try with the beauty blender. I'm not sure if it's too late now, because I feel like, whoa, like you would not even need to set this with powder. It's, yeah, wow, okay. It doesn't feel fresh, that's what I'm trying to say. It doesn't have that nice little like glow that I like in foundations now, but let me try with, yeah. Sponge. Sadly, I'm a little bit underwhelmed, I think. But that's usually what happens when you watch a video and you have these, like, as soon as your expectations are set, it's highly unlikely they will be either exceeded or even met sometimes. Yeah. I just don't think it's doing my skin any favors. Like, it's got a good coverage, but I like a fresh finish, and this is very matte. But I know it says oil control, and I know it's 24 hours, so I feel like 24 hour foundations would have to be quite like, which is the whole reason you buy it. But yeah, I think it's just a case of having different needs with my foundation these days. This was meant to be like my light, fairer skin shade. No, that's definitely like my tan shade. So shade 3 is probably never going to get used. I can understand why it has mixed reviews now. Not that I've read the reviews, so I don't actually know what the reason is, but yeah, I'm assuming it's because of just different skin types. Although mine's not dry anymore. So I feel like if you had dry skin, this was not your thing. And I did try, I like layered the primer and used the Fenty one, which would be similar to the Smashbox one for sure. But it definitely looks nice. I'm not saying it doesn't look nice. I'm not gonna like sit here and lie. it looked quite flawless in terms of like it's evened everything out quite quickly. You can still see this bit, which I think is fairly like understandable. That's what there though, you can still see a little bit. The spots on my cheeks have been fairly well covered. I'll apply my favorite Too Faced Born This Way concealer. I'm going to use the Hourglass Translucent Setting Powder to set my face, because it's very light and we all know I do not need much powder after that foundation. I'm just gonna do it very lightly underneath my eyes. You can see like, can you see how it's emphasized my lines here? I don't know if you can see that. So it looks cakey because it's... My camera just stopped recording, so I don't know what was captured and what wasn't, but let's just start fresh. I initially reached for my Fenty bronzer, but I think we're gonna stick with the Hourglass one because it's got more of a grayish tinge and I don't think I need like an orangey tinge right now. I think the foundation's already taken care of that. So yeah, ambient lighting bronzer in nude bronze light. I love you, baby. Ooh, beautiful. Oh, I love this product. Definitely a good like full glam foundation. If that's your goal. I'd actually like to try, what are they called? The Fenty Brow MVP, Ultra Fine Brow Pencil and Styler. Ooh, ooh, that was like a little mini toothbrush, that's weird. I don't know if that's, okay, I'll give it a shot. Yeah, I'm not sure if the color's gonna be too. I'll try it before I judge. Ouch, it's really sharp. Slicing my eyebrows off one by one. The color's actually really nice. I think regardless, I'm always going to prefer to use a powder. I just have more control and I feel like these pencils always pull my eyebrow hairs out. Maybe my hand's too heavy. I don't think so. I think it's just the way, yeah, I don't know. How do people use these little eyebrow pencils every day and not lose eyebrow hairs? I'm brushing them through with this little comb thing, which actually is kind of growing on me, and they're just coming out. I'm gonna have little bald patches on my eyes soon. I don't feel like I'm going like either. So what's going on? So that's the brow product. Definitely really nice. The color is actually perfect, so I will eat my words there. It just looks kind of like greenish in the pencil, but when it's actually on, it adjusts quite nicely. I will still just always use a powder because it's so much easier to control, but beautiful product. And this little brush here actually grew on me. It's just nice seeing something different, I guess. Not the same old spoolie. And probably easier to keep clean too, I'd imagine. Anyway, I'm gonna finish my eyebrows and my eyes and then I'll come back and go from there. Okay, so I finished my makeup. I used these lashes from Huda Beauty. It's hard to see because of the packaging, but yeah. Hoodie number 23. They're very, very intense, very long and dramatic, but right up my alley. In terms of the foundation, I mean, it is nice, but I'm not gonna lose my mind over it. I would, like, I always think about these things in the situation of, like, after this video is filmed, will I go and use it again over my foundations that I know that I love and are amazing? And for this one, the answer is probably no, because there wasn't really anything that, like, stood out to me that I can't find in my other foundations. I just can't see myself using it over my Fenty or Too Faced Born This Way, because at least the Too Faced one has like hydration and like a soft natural finish if that's what you want. And the Fenty one, it doesn't, like even if this one's so thin and light, I still feel like I've got foundation on my face. The formula is amazing in that a little bit of product goes a very long way, but somehow it still feels like it's there. It feels like not heavy, but I can tell that I'm wearing makeup. Whereas the Fenty one, sorry, I'm daydreaming and it gets fun. The Fenty one feels so much lighter. It doesn't feel like, I don't know, it's just a different feeling. I mean, I think I'm looking at it in the camera and it looks much, I think it looks better in the camera. We'll see once I go to edit, but right now, I just feel like I'm wearing a lot of makeup, and I am wearing a lot of makeup, but I don't always get that kind of feeling with my other foundations. I don't know, I guess it just comes down to different preferences. Yeah, it's gonna be hard to find a foundation that everybody loves the exact same way for the same reasons, but I will see how it lasts throughout the rest of the day. It is 11:48 in the morning. I'll show you my skin up close. I don't even know if you can see anything. It's definitely nice and I can see why some people would really, really like it. Hey guys, it's 7:30 at night and I just wanted to give you an update on the foundation. The pimple here, because the skin was already dry, it's kind of like flaked off, but that's fine. In general, I actually prefer it probably now to when I first applied it, purely because my skin has like released oil, I guess, and it makes it look more just hydrated. My skin doesn't look so flat. My forehead's still pretty matte, just around my T-zone, which is pretty standard. Of course, I took my lashes off, my lipstick's come off, I've already had dinner and everything, so everything else, like the highlight looks amazing. You can still see the blush, contour. That spot is still pretty well covered. Overall, it's lasted quite well. I did notice when I looked in the mirror before that the lines around my mouth are actually like surprisingly good and intact. They haven't separated as much as most foundations would have by now. In fact, I was actually really surprised by that. It's weird. I prefer how it looks now, even though it's old and it's been worn. And I guess that's actually why I like it, because it just looks like it's more natural and fresh and dewy rather than just makeup-y, flat, matte. Would I wear it again? I mean, I'm sure I will, maybe, but like it's not going to be my first choice, so in which case I don't know how often I will wear it, but I'll definitely give it another chance. Maybe it would be better with the Smashbox primer, I don't know, but overall, yeah, not life-changing, not as amazing as I thought it would be, but still a great foundation, great longevity. A little goes a very long way. Price is all right. Yeah. What did you guys think? Have you tried it? If so, what are your thoughts? Or do you want to try it? Will you try it now if you haven't tried it? Anyway, thank you so much for watching. I love you guys and I hope to see you all in my next video. Bye everyone.